I've sewn along the edges of the interfacing. Now I'm going to trim off the excess, which is leaving. I've sketched this at about a distance of about half an inch. So I'll just cut into that. Just trim away all the excess. And then all these corners, trim right to the edge of all the corners, going as close as possible to the edge of the stitching. Use a good pair of scissors, which has possibly has a sharp point. Now if you leave the end of the point of the scissor at the end of the stitching, just snip into that up till the point, and don't go as such, because you will tend to go into the stitching itself unless you've got a very, very good hand. So keep it slightly ajar and just cut up till the edge of the stitching on all the sharp points. These scissors are not brilliant. Now if by mistake you do cut into the stitching, reinforce the stitching going all the way along the edges again. It's actually a good idea to reinforce the stitching. So before I turn this over, what I'm going to do is, because there were quite a few corners here, I don't want to have accidentally gone over onto the stitching and then to realize later on, because to remedy the situation afterwards it's more difficult to do it at the starting point. Now I have attached these pieces on the inside, and I've turned it over, and basically I'm going to attach this on the back of the neck line. Now before I actually go ahead with this, the green ribbon that I've used on top of the piece of fabric, I've just turned this fabric over and then attached green ribbon on top of it. I'm going to attach the green ribbon around here also. And I'm actually going to just show you exactly what it is that I'm going to do with this. So I'm going to take the camera over to the machine and just show you as I'm sewing the ribbon onto this. I just pinned this into place in a few places just to keep the neckline in shape. Now the ribbon that I'm going to attach on, I am going to leave a slight bit of a room here as I get to the corner. I'm going to angle this out, angle that back up again, turn the ribbon over. I'm actually going to cut this ribbon. Turn the ribbon over into the shape and stitch over, turn this all the way around. Every time I'm coming to an angle, I am angling this out so that I've got Now, only attempt doing this if you're confident and if you think you're good at what you're about to attempt. Because the last thing you want to do is I'm showing you this, but like I said, only attempt doing it if you feel very confident that you can, and by all means, try it out on something which is just something that is experimental and not your expensive garment. This is just a very, very cheap sari that if it's just good with this, I think it's going to give it a very beautiful effect. To go back to the beginning and I'm going to start stitching around again. Now at some spaces here it is actually just slightly coming out, and what I did was just push it back into place with the tip of the needle. Basically, that's what the back of. I just need to press this. Now, the other thing I'm going to do before I do anything else is I'm going to dart this. I've left the dart marks on. I've ironed the dart marks in, and I'm going to just quickly. I'm just going to quickly dart it as well, so that it saves me the job. Not coming back to this and doing it all over again.